Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making peanut butter cupcakes. Those are really good this time of year, and if you haven't tried them, I think you'll like this recipe. We're starting with some flour. This is all-purpose flour, 2 cups. So I put that in a bowl where I can mix around the flour along with salt. I have 1/2 teaspoon of salt and baking powder. I have 3 teaspoons of baking powder. So I'm just going to stir that. You can sieve this if you like to, but it really is not necessary as long as you stir it very well. Next, I have 1/4 cup of butter, which is softened. You can see it's very soft. It's been sitting at room temperature for some time. And I'm adding to that 1/2 cup of creamy peanut butter. Now, this is probably the maximum amount that you would want to use. Some of you might like to use less. You can go down to 1/4 cup. And it will still taste good. Also add 1 cup of white sugar. Now I'm going to mix this with an electric mixer on medium speed. I'll start with slow and then move up. Now I have 2 well-beaten eggs that go into my mixture. I'm going to beat them in. Now I have 3/4 cup of milk, and I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. Just stir that together. And what you have is your vanilla and milk mixture, and you have your dry ingredients, which have been stirred together. What you're going to do is put in some of your dry ingredients, and then use your mixer to mix this. Then you'll add some of your milk mixture and continue to alternate, ending with the dry ingredient. And here is our nice creamy cupcake batter. At the end, I was sure to scrape down the sides and then I beat it thoroughly for about 2 minutes. I wanted to have a lot of air beat into it. I'm not making muffins where you give it a minimal amount of stirring. So this is a cupcake and we want it to be light and airy. I'm using an ice cream scoop because that gives the right amount, and we'll just place it down in here and bring up the amount that fills it and come over and put it in a pan, a muffin pan, that I've put paper liners in. So it's all ready to go, and I'm kind of spilling this, but get close enough to it so that it's not really messy and turn that out. It should fill it 2/3 of the way full, up to 3/4 of the way full. So I'm going to take this batter and even it out and try to fill one muffin tin. If it takes more, I have another one ready here for it, but probably it's going to give about 12, maybe a few more than that. Honestly, if you want to make this into a cake, you can use 2 9-inch cake pans and bake it according to the instructions I'm going to give in just a minute, and you'll have a cake that you can ice and serve that way. You can have a 13x9x2 pan, and you can have a rectangular cake that way. But I'm just going to make cupcakes, so I'll come back when these are all completed and give you the cooking instructions. Here we have 1 dozen filled muffin tins, and I had a little bit of batter left over, but not enough to start another muffin tin. I didn't feel like it was worth it. So these are filled pretty high because I was getting that last little bit in. So they may actually come up and overflow and have a little bit of muffin top, but everybody says that's the best part anyway. So we'll see what they do in a 350-degree oven. I'm going to watch them carefully, but I expect that they'll take maybe 15 minutes or so. I will use a toothpick test, and I'll know when they're done when the toothpick comes out clean. These peanut butter cupcakes have just come out of the oven. They took 15 minutes to get to this point, and this one looked like the tallest, maybe that one. Let's go with that one. I'm going to put in a toothpick and see if it comes out clean. It does, and that is in the deepest one, I think, of all that we have. Now, these are very hot right now. Let's just pick one of these, and that's a little bit stuck right there. That's the muffin top that is sticking because, you know, the paper liner is not sticking. And I use black paper liners, so that's why they're black. They're not burned at all. But it's a very nice cupcake. Very hot right now. What I'm going to do is let them sit in the pan for just about 5 minutes, and then I'll let them cool on the rack below, and they'll be free to the open air, and then we'll put them on a plate. Here are our peanut butter cupcakes, and they're all finished, and they've cooled a bit. They're still warm, so they're really good to eat right now. I'm going to take one over here and peel off this black liner to let you see what the actual color of the cupcake is. If I can get a hold of that. There is a very much of a muffin top on this one, which some people really like those better than they like the cupcake. But here's what the cupcake looks like. And when you have the muffin top there, it makes it just want to seal very tightly, and it's hard to get that paper off. Usually it won't be. So now we're cutting down through just to let you see the texture before I take a taste. How good does that look? That really looks like it will taste good. I'm going to take a bite of it. I have waiting for me some pomegranate tea. So I think that would be a good pairing. And here we go. I'll go through the muffin top and into the cupcake. I like that crunchy muffin top. That's really the best part. Although it's a nice, rich, peanutty flavor. So if you like peanut butter and you're not allergic to it and your kids are not allergic to it, you might want to try this recipe.